mean? What's wrong? Why is that lady the dog?
Hey guys, so today I want to talk to you about dealing with the public with a service dog. But before we get started, I just want to point out that Farabee and I have matching sweatshirts. I'm really excited about that. So they're both sparkly. Mine's a little bit of a different color, pinky gray, and hers is more of a light pink. We got them from, hers is from Petco, mine's from Gap. I'm really excited about this. Anyways, so on with the topic. So I want to talk to you about dealing with the public, like in a positive way. So one thing in particular, we've run into a few people, a few mothers with children who the children have, you know, been super excited to see a dog and they've been like, "Mom, a dog," or, you know, whatever they say, like loudly because they're excited and we're in a store where a dog wouldn't be. And then these people I'm talking about in particular are parents who have told their kid like, "Shh, it's working," or "Shh, it's a service dog," or whatever. And, you know, tried to, you know, the mom has known that their kid cannot come up and pet the dog. And then in two of the incidences that I'm referring to, I don't know why I did four, two of the incidences that we've come across, the mom has been put in a situation by her child because her child's asking questions loudly. You know, the kid's like, "What does that mean? What's wrong? Why is that lady a dog?" You know, and like they're curious because they don't know and they've never maybe seen such a thing. And the mom has been trying to explain like quietly to the kid in like almost like the first incident, you could tell the lady was not sure if it was okay to talk about it out loud. And she was just kind of like whispering, like really, really quiet, you know, she was kind of like, we were at a checkout. And so I was like over here and she was like over here, like on opposite sides. And she was like trying to tell her kid quiet, but like, you know, I'm standing right there. And so she just happened to look up and I was like this, gave her a thumbs up and started shaking my head because she was explaining it like perfect. So if you see that happen, definitely like, you know, give the parent a thumbs up, like shake your head, you know, let them know, yeah, you're doing good. Like that's good. That is, you're explaining it right. And then the mom actually said, she said, "So that's right, right?" And I started, you know, I kind of jumped in and helped her a little bit. And I was like, yeah, you know, she can catch stuff before I know anything's going on. Also keep in mind, whenever you're talking to like a parent and a child like that, you need to make it be like as kid friendly as possible. So, you know, so keep it kid friendly and just try to explain like very childlike so that it's not anything that the parent's gonna have to have a whole conversation then about like medical problems. But yeah, so that was awesome. And another time we ran into somebody and kind of in passing, once again, very much the same situation where the kid's like, you know, extremely excited, loud about the dog and the mom's like whispering. And with that one, we were kind of in a situation where we were stopped at the same place. We were in a store shopping and I kind of did the same thing on that one, but the mom didn't like give me room to really say anything. So I didn't say anything. I just kind of gave her a thumbs up and shook my head and said thank you or something to her, because it's important whenever you see a parent trying to stop their child from talking to your dog and they're also explaining why it is and what a service dog does, it's important that we encourage those conversations because it's not anything to be ashamed of. And I think people who don't have anything going on, you know, visible or not, where it's a difference and it's a clear difference, I think a lot of times people don't know if they should like be quiet about it or if it's something to be, like if it's sad or if it's a shameful thing, like not, I don't know, you know what I'm talking about though. So it's important to kind of normalize that, like not in a, I don't know how you would word that, but just to normalize it and make it be like, no, it's fine to talk about it out loud. Like this is part of life, you know, it's okay. Good job for you, you know, trying to explain to your child what's going on and, you know, and not just shutting them down, because kids are curious and that's okay. There's nothing wrong with being curious. I would be curious too. I mean, I know I was an animal lover whenever I was growing up. I definitely would have been the kid who would be like, "Oh, I had a dog," you know? And none of those people had asked to interact with the dog. So, or with Farabee, sorry. With the dog. none of those people had asked like if they could interact with her at all. So that was perfect. And obviously, you know, that's what you want. A perfect situation is like that, where the kid's like, mom, a dog, mom shuts it down as far as like, no, we're not going to the dog. This is why. Perfect. Great job. That's why I was like, thumbs up. Yay. Good job, mama, to both of them. Like, awesome. And then we've also had people who will just kind of shut it down and not answer their kids' questions. And that's kind of disappointing. I mean, I hope whenever they got away from us, I hope they did talk about it. But the reason I feel like that's disappointing is because kids are naturally curious. And I feel like too, depending on the age of the child, like maybe that might make them feel like the dogs who are out with people like that are scary. Maybe that's why they don't talk about it. Or I don't know, it just kind of like, I don't know. I feel like that's not the best way to handle it. Obviously, I'm not a parent to a human child, so I don't know. But I just feel like an open conversation and saying like that helps that person so we can't interact with it is much better than we don't talk about it. So anyway, so those were awesome experiences. And we've also run across a few people. I'm trying to talk about only positive stuff, by the way, guys, because obviously we could talk about bad, but the positive people. We've run across a few older people, like one of the days that we've gone to the grocery store recently, they had like the senior bus where they, I guess they get people from the assisted living community or whatever, and they, you know, they all pile on the bus and go to the grocery store. And we went on that day, and it was just totally by chance. But the amount of sweet little, you know, old granny ladies who are like, oh, she's so beautiful, and like, you know I can't talk to her, but she's so pretty, you know, and like want to ask questions and stuff. Depending on the day, like that can be like a little bit like, whoa. But I always try to be super nice with people who like know they can't talk to the dog, but they're wanting to compliment. Like, that is, I mean, that's so sweet that they even, you know, want to say anything. And I don't know, I appreciate that. Although obviously we know the best thing is for people to ignore, but at the same time, I kind of give like older people, if you're old enough to be my grandma, I give you a pass. And also obviously little kids, because little kids don't know. But as far as the little old people, and like one lady, I felt like she was kind of like lingering to like just watch Farabee. And Farabee has grown up enough at this point for like regular things like grocery store trips, for her to be more okay with somebody doing that. Whenever she was like much younger, even over the summer, she was not at that point yet. So it was kind of almost upsetting for me, because I felt like, number one, I don't know if somebody's judging us, and also it was distracting for me and for her. But now, you know, 6 months later, Farabee started going to the grocery stores in June of this year, and like she has not gone with me since June, basically. And it's December, the end of December now. So I feel like I'm much more comfortable with her, and like I feel like I can, not that I didn't trust her before, but I feel like I know that she's gonna act, you know, pretty good. She doesn't get distracted as easily, and if she does, she's pretty easy to regain focus. So I don't know, I just think it's super sweet with old people who just think your dog is beautiful, and then also like little kids with parents who are trying to do the right thing and explain. So anyways, I just wanted to hop on here and encourage you guys to try to listen to people before you jump on them for saying something about your dog or whatever, because I know I have done this before too, and I'm not proud of it, but I have before heard somebody saying something about my dog and me just immediately pop off and be like, yeah, she's a service dog, she's working. And I try really hard not to do that, but obviously I'm human, and obviously I have bad days. And if I feel like I'm very overwhelmed, and then it's like the fifth or sixth person that day who's saying something, it sometimes is like, oh my God, just leave me alone. But I found if I can really try to like actually just keep my mouth shut and let whoever is saying something say whatever it is, 9 times out of 10, they seriously will just make a comment and be like, your dog is beautiful, or, oh, she's so good, or something like that. Like, if I don't say anything, and then I can just say thank you and keep on going. Or like I said, with the incident with the kids, with the moms, you know, if I had just popped off as soon as that kid had said, mom, a dog, if I'd be like, she's a service dog, that would have shut it down. You know what I mean? And like, that would have made it awkward for everyone involved, but also it would have shut down that conversation for the mom and the child. So I'm really glad that I was able to just, not that I was able to be quiet, but I'm really glad that I've kind of changed my mindset on that and just kind of made it be like, I'm gonna be quiet and let whoever it is completely speak whatever sentence or thought they have. And then if they try to approach her, obviously that's different, but I do try to say thank you and stuff. Like if somebody comments on my dog, you know, if somebody says, oh, her little boots, or oh, she's so pretty, or oh, look at that hair, or oh, I love your dog. Like, we have people who, Fairby has a lot of hair. I mean, I know you guys don't know without looking at her, but I mean, you know, she kind of has hair like a, what is it, a cockatoo? She has a lot of hair. And then also whenever we go out, for the majority of trips, she wears boots. We do get comments of, oh my God, look at that hair, a lot. And then we also get comments on the boots. And I know I don't have to respond, but at the same time, I don't wanna be a jerk, you know? Like people, it makes people happy to see her too. And if they're just simply giving a compliment, there's no reason to be rude and there's no reason to not say thank you. If they're trying to approach her, obviously that's different. In the whole entire time that I've been taking Fairby to do stuff, like I'm not talking about places that are dog friendly, because dog friendly places, the lines are so blurred, we can't include those in this. But at Walmart, we had that one lady who was rude. I have not had anyone else really be outright just a jerk. Now, whenever we've been to things that are dog friendly, I had someone actually run up and touch Fairby, and this was at the Christmas tree lighting. I cut that out because we don't need all that. And then I have had people, whenever we've gone to the farmer's market, I've had people be taking pictures of her without my consent and like coming up to her in that way, but it's dog friendly. And I don't like it, but at the same time, you kind of have to know whenever you're going into a dog friendly situation, people are not gonna really even think that your dog is not just a regular dog there. They're gonna be like, oh wow, a dog there. And we've had the same thing happen at Petco. Whenever we go to Petco, I have had people run up and just be like, puppy, and like start talking to her. I've got to the point at Petco, I don't even vest her because we go so infrequent and it's not gonna hurt her. I know she's still got my back. Like if I start to have a panic attack, she will immediately like get me. It doesn't matter vest or no vest. So I've got to where if we go places that are pet friendly, I just don't vest her. I do put my leash wrap that says like no talking, no touching, no eye contact, just because I feel like I want to have that extra layer of like, because I really don't want people to do stuff, but at the same time, it's kind of, I don't want to say it's a lost cause. What is going on? Oh, the fridge looks like it's part of my my hair. So it's not really a lost cause, but it kind of is. And it also, it forces me, I feel like, to have to, you know, not let her be a dog in certain places. And I think it's fine for her to get to be a dog, like at Petco. It's where the pets go. Like, yeah, she can go be a dog there. She can walk around and you know, interact and stuff. It doesn't hurt her. Doesn't hurt me either. So, and she can tell a difference. Like she does know, because our Petco that we go to is next to a grocery store. So she knows as soon as we leave Petco, if we put her vest on and go in the grocery store, we can go back to back like that. And she completely changes her attitude. Like she doesn't act like a, you know, a crazy little puppy in the grocery store just because we just went to Petco. So anyways, all of that to say, interacting with the public can be totally crazy. And I, of course, am not saying like, let people run up and pet your dog in the grocery store, because that's not the thing. But just try to like listen and let people say what they're gonna say. Oftentimes they're just being nice and giving a compliment, and they might not have questions. They might just say, oh my God, your dog's beautiful. And if you just say thank you and keep walking, then that's it. You can acknowledge people and be super nice and say thank you so much, or thank you, or whatever, and keep going. And in the conversation in that way. Obviously, you're gonna have people who do wanna ask questions, and it's up to you how you handle that. Obviously, if somebody tries to touch her, I am gonna block them and tell them no. But I'm just talking about in general. We see so many, as service dog handlers, we see so many people who are just angry about people who, I went out and somebody like was telling me how cute my dog was like 10 times. And I've even made a video about that where I feel like it's irritating. And here's the thing. I think a few months back, I did feel like it was kind of annoying, but at the same time, I kind of have tried to shift my mindset and say, wait a minute, why do I feel like this is irritating for someone to tell me my dog is cute? I do think it's annoying if somebody runs up and tries to touch her. Yeah, that's annoying. But I don't feel like there's any reason for me to find it irritating that somebody tells me my dog is cute. You know, of course, it is cool just to walk through the store and not have anybody say anything too. But at the same time, like, I don't know. I just feel like being positive is so much better than having like a mindset of it's aggravating. Now, can it get annoying? Of course. But if you can just shift your mindset into that like gratitude of like, well, thank you for telling me my dog is cute. I super appreciate you. Have a good day. Attitude rather than if you have that mindset whenever you're walking into the store, like, so mad, I hope no one interacts with us, you know, and you have that attitude, then it's just not as healthy, number one, mentally. But also, there's no reason to be that way. Anyways, so mindset is everything. If you guys found this interesting or helpful at all, please hit the subscribe button. We'd love to see you again. Also hit the notification bell so that you know when we upload. We usually upload Wednesdays at 10 a.m. Eastern time. So we will see you soon. Bye guys.